Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. So today's video is going to be a little bit different from my usual makeup tutorials. This video is all about makeup therapy right from scratch on my brown, deep, dusky Indian skin. The concept of this video is completely inspired by Shalini Mandal. I love her YouTube channel and her. She has this amazing concept of brown skin makeup therapy, which I absolutely love watching, as well as I find it very, very inspiring too, especially for dusky or deeper Indian skin girls. I know exactly how it feels to be a person with a darker skin tone in our Indian society, so I really wanted to make this video on my channel as well. I have quite a bit of pigmentation, acne spots, fresh pimples, dark circles, as well as facial hair on my skin. There is no artificial lighting in this room except one tube light on this side. But other than that, I have come real close to my window today to get all the natural sunlight that I can get. This is how my real skin looks like up close. I have quite a bit of pigmentation, acne spots, fresh pimples, and even dark circles and facial hair. My lips are also very, very pigmented. Only a little bit of pink is shown on the lower lip right here on the center, but other than that, it is very, very pigmented as well. So let's start from the scratch. I'm gonna wash my face using the Dermavive Hydra Cleanser. This is a very, very good cleanser and it is very gentle and mild on the skin. Even if you have sensitive skin types, it would work absolutely perfect on your skin type. Once that is done, I'm gonna wash my face using tap water. I also like to keep a separate face towel. This is a microfiber towel. I'm also gonna do a bit of scrubbing on the skin today. This is just gonna make sure that your makeup sits properly on top of the skin. I'm gonna use the Wishful Yo Glow Enzyme Scrub. This is very, very expensive but really, really effective. It literally feels like a baby's skin after you use this product. Also, this one has very, very mild, tiny little scrubbing particles on it. I'm guessing even if you have acne-prone skin, this is gonna be very, very mild and gentle exfoliator for your skin type. It is so, so satisfying to use this scrub and see results instantly. Also, I wanted to put it out there, the lighting is gonna keep fluctuating since I'm using natural light in today's video. Okay, exfoliation of the skin is done. Now I'm gonna remove all of the excess facial hair from my face. Before doing that, I'm gonna use some rose water spray onto my face. So I'm just gonna try to remove the excessive hair using gentle strokes. Just make sure to lubricate your skin before you use a facial razor, and also I'm gonna avoid all of the areas wherever I have fresh pimples or acne. Shaving also tends to exfoliate your skin from the surface, so again your makeup is gonna sit so beautifully on top of your skin. After this step, if you want, you can use a serum as well. I'm gonna go right into my moisturizer, for which I'm gonna use the Nutriderm Vitamin E Moisturizing Lotion, which I absolutely love. I'm taking a nice amount of the moisturizer and apply it all over the face, eye and neck. This is such a great moisturizer for all skin types. It adds the perfect amount of moisture without making your skin go dry or matte completely. Since this is daytime, I'm gonna use a sunscreen as well. This is the Sunstop SPF 30 sunscreen. I'm taking a good amount of the sunscreen and apply and massage all over the face and neck. This sunscreen is water resistant, non-greasy, and dermatologist tested and recommended. It's very, very mattifying on the skin, unlike other sunscreens which really make you look greasy and oily. Now I'm gonna let all of my skincare sink into my skin properly for about 10 minutes and then I'm gonna begin with my makeup. I kind of forgot one thing to do, which is a lip balm. So instead of the lip balm, I have been using the Too Faced Lip Injection Extreme. This is sort of like a lip gloss for your lips, but it adds that plumpness and juiciness to your lips. So I've been obsessed with this product recently for my lips. I always apply this before I begin with my makeup. For primer, I'm going to use the Flower Beauty Perfecting Primer. This is sort of like a silicone based primer which just helps in sort of filling up all your pores and gives that even surface on the skin. So I'm just focusing that on the main areas of my face and blend it out using my fingertips. I'm gonna let the primer do its thing for about 2 minutes and then I'm gonna apply any other base product on top. I have quite a bit of pigmentation to be taken care of, so I'm gonna use the Pack Take Cover Concealer in the shade Rusty Orange, which is basically an orange corrector to counteract all these hyperpigmented areas on my skin. So I'm just gonna take a little bit of that color corrector and apply it near the mouth area where I have the most darkness, and a little bit on the under eyes where I have dark circles, as well as a little tiny bit on top of my acne spots. Immediately I'm going to take my damp beauty blender, this is from e.l.f., and blend all of these color corrector. I'm blending the color corrector so that the layers that I apply on top of this don't go cakey. So it is very important that you blend the color corrector in place. Now I'm taking the Pack Take Cover Concealer in the shade Twisted Toffee, which is a very, very close match to my own complexion, and apply it right on the dark circles here, on top of the eyelids, on my acne marks and around the mouth area. For foundation, I'm going to be using the MAC Studio Fix Fluid in the shade NC46, which is my exact skin color in a bottle. This is such a great foundation, either for professional use or for personal use as well. So I'm just going to take a little bit of that foundation and just apply it sort of on the cheek and chin area of my face. I'm going to take a buffing brush, this one is from Amazon, and just blend everything out softly and gently. And whatever is left on the brush, I'm just going to run it on my neck as well as on my ear to make sure that there is no demarcation. I'm just going to do a little bit of highlighting underneath my eyes because I do have very hollow shaped eyes, so I just want to bring this area forward. If you do not wish to highlight, then you can totally skip this step, but I have been really enjoying highlighting my under eyes. For that, I'm going to use the Maybelline Fit Me Concealer in the shade Honey. So I'm just going to apply a little bit here. This is a couple of shades lighter than my own complexion, so this is just going to bring this area forward and make it look brighter. I'm using a concealer blending brush from Forever 52 and again use gentle dabbing motion to blend out the concealer. Now my under eyes look perfectly nice and brightened up. Before setting my face with some powder, I'm just gonna take the same beauty sponge and go all over my face to remove any excess product. To set my face, I'm gonna use the Mars Cosmetics Translucent Loose Powder in the shade Banana. Press the powder gently. This is a very, very beautiful, inexpensive loose powder which I have been loving lately. While the powder is baking, I'm just gonna do a bit of eyebrow filling and eye makeup. So I'm taking the Lakme Micro Brow Perfector in the shade Charcoal to fill in my brows. This has a spoolie on one end and an eyebrow pencil on the other end. So I'm taking this spoolie first and just combing through my brows. Now I'm going to take the pencil side, which is super, super thin, so it is easy for you to create that hair-like strokes on your eyebrows. So I'm just going to use this to fill in my eyebrows. I really like a well-groomed and thick brow. I think it really defines your face, and a thicker eyebrow always gives you that youthful look to your face. For the eyes, I'm gonna keep it extremely simple. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take this blush palette from Forever 52. I'm just gonna mix these two shades from the palette. So I've taken that on a blending brush and dust off the excess and just run that through my crease. Once that is done, I'm just gonna brush off the excess powder on the under eyes. And I'm also gonna use the same loose powder to set the rest of the face as well. Just to make sure that my face doesn't get oily throughout the day, since I have an extremely oily skin type. Next, for the eyes, I'm gonna take the Lakme Iconic Kohl in the shade Classic Brown, which is like a deep chocolatey brown kajal, and apply that on top of my eyelids as a liner. Once I've applied the kajal, I'm just gonna use my ring finger to soften the liner out to give that smudged out look. Since this is a brown kajal, it's not gonna look as harsh as a black kajal would do. Before applying mascara, I'm just gonna curl both of my lashes using the e.l.f. eyelash curler. This is an amazing eyelash curler. It just adds that beautiful curl and lift to your lashes and holds it pretty long as well. I'm just gonna do about 10 pumps on each eye. For mascara, I'm gonna be using the Mars Fabulash Lengthening and Volumizing Mascara. This is an absolute stunning mascara. This can be compared easily with any other high-end mascaras that are available. It is so good. So I'm just gonna do several coats of this mascara to my top and bottom eyelashes. Look at the amount of volume, length and separation this mascara gives. It is amazing. I'm gonna bronze up my skin ever so slightly using the Revolution Bacon Blot Powder in the shade Deep Dark. I love this powder to bronze up my skin. So I'm just gonna apply this to the perimeters of my face. This is such a pretty tone for my dusky complexion. It looks absolutely beautiful on the skin and it is very soft and easy to blend as well. I'm also applying that to the sides of the nose as well to make it look more sharper and cohesive with the rest of the face. For blusher, I'm gonna use the same Forever 52 palette. I'm gonna pick up this rosy matte blush. I'm just gonna apply that to the apples of the cheeks to add a bit of flush of color to my face. This blusher is extremely pigmented, so you have to use a very light hand, otherwise it can go overboard. To highlight my face, I'm gonna use this peachy gold reflective highlighter from the same palette and apply that to the tops of my cheekbones, the center of the nose, the cupid's bow and chin. It's a very soft peachy gold, finely milled highlighter, especially for dusky complexions. It's a beautiful golden shade of highlighter. I'm gonna do my lips now. So I'm just gonna remove the two-phased lip injection thing from my lips. First, I'm gonna take the Lakme Absolute Matte Melt Liquid Lipstick in the shade Cocoa Butter, which is a deep chocolatey shade of liquid lipstick. I love the formula of this liquid lipstick as well. It is very thin, lightweight and comfortable on the lips. So I'm just gonna apply that all over the lips. On the center of the lips, I'm gonna use the Lakme Forever Matte Liquid Lip Color in the shade Mauve Party. I'm loving the lip concoction. It is looking super natural tone for my skin tone. To set all of my makeup, I'm gonna use the Milani Make It Last setting spray. The setting spray is gonna make sure that the makeup is well put for throughout the day, as well as the makeup melts and meshes with your own skin. So I just did my hair and came back and this is how the makeup looks like. The texture, the bumps, the crease lines, the laugh lines, everything is still a little bit more visible. It is not completely vanished from the skin and the makeup itself is sitting on top of the skin. It never becomes a second layer of your skin. At the end of the day, makeup is makeup and it is gonna sit on top of your skin and not blend or mix in with your own skin. Even a little bit of the pigmentation is still peeking through from the sides of the mouth, which I absolutely do not mind. It is completely normal and it is totally fine. The texture, pores and acne bumps on the cheeks are still visible even with makeup on, and it is completely fine. You cannot hide or erase everything with makeup. So this is it for today's video. I really hope that you guys enjoyed watching me create this soft, natural makeup look on my brown, dusky, imperfect skin. All the products that I use in today's video will be listed in the description box. Make sure to give this video a huge thumbs up, comment, and do not forget to subscribe to my channel for more such videos. Hit the bell notification to get notified each time I upload a new video on my channel. Take care of yourselves and I shall see you guys soon in my next one. Bye.